Okay, so now you have some time to explore the behavior of one-dimensional deterministic linear dynamical systems. We are going to make it a little more general and introduce the concept of more than one variable. So when you consider the dynamical systems of more than one variable, the simplest possible thing for you to do is just write them down separately. And that works quite well as long as they have nothing to do with each other. But let's go back to our bunny example and imagine that in this world, not only do we have bunnies, we also have foxes. We all know that foxes like eating bunnies. And so the rate at which the number of bunnies changes is not independent of the number of foxes, and the same vice versa. We can write the way in which they're dependent on each other by adding a couple of terms. So now an x1 dot, the rate at which the bunnies change, is not just a function of x1, but also a function of x2. Now in the system of equations, the system of linear equations I've written on the left-hand side here, we can write exactly the same system of equations in matrix and vector form, and it's just a little more compact. It makes everything a little nicer. And what you can see here is instead of having just a state x, we have a state vector, which is x1 and x2 stacked on top of each other. So here x is x dot equals a matrix A times, again, the state vector x. Now, in this two-dimensional deterministic linear dynamical system, a really cool thing happens, which is that the behavior of the system depends on the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of my matrix A. For a primer and a reminder of eigen decomposition, I strongly encourage you to watch the recommended videos in the prereqs on YouTube. It's a really excellent reminder of what eigen decomposition is all about, and it's pretty important for understanding what I'm about to tell you next. And so the thing about these eigenvectors and eigenvalues is that now we can write down the solution for this two-dimensional deterministic linear system as a weighted sum of the eigen decomposition. So I'm going to break this down for you a little bit here. If you just look at this first term, you'll see that it looks very similar to the solution of our 1D system from previously, right? But now, instead of having a number lambda, this lambda happens to be the first eigenvalue of A, and it's paired with the first eigenvector of A. So this is V1 transpose and V here, okay? Sandwiched by the initial conditions. And then we have exactly the same form of the equation for the second eigenvalue and second eigenvector of A, okay? So the eigen decomposition is a really important concept here because it allows us to determine separate directions in which the linear dynamical system changes. And just like before, the intuition here is that the value of lambda 1 and lambda 2 tells you about the direction of the growth. And the eigenvectors v1 and v2 tell you about the spatial dimensions in which those changes are taking place. So what we can look at here is a something that is a way of synthesizing all that information. And so this is what's called a phase portrait or a stream plot is what we're going to be plotting here in the next tutorial. What we're looking at these arrows, which tells us about the flow of the system if you're looking at x1 versus x2. And the flow of this particular system, I'm not even going to show you the corresponding A matrix here because all that's really important are the two eigenvectors and their respective eigenvalues. And by looking at these stream plots, you'll be able to see the flow of the system and what's going to happen after a really long time. And it's entirely dependent on the eigenvalues and their corresponding directions. So this blue eigenvalue here is 0.1, as we told us, above zero, which means it's growing. And this red eigenvalue here is 1, which means it is also growing, but it's growing faster. And you can see that in their respective orientations, initially, the flow, if you're really, really close to this blue eigenvector, you follow the blue eigenvector. But after a really long time, all the trajectories start following the direction of the red eigenvector. If one of the eigenvalues is positive and the other one is not positive, it's negative, then we have something that's called a saddle. So if you follow the eigenvectors here, you can see that because this red eigenvector has a negative eigenvalue, things are contracting. This is exponential decay, okay? So things are decaying and going towards the origin along the red direction, but they're growing along the blue direction because that eigenvalue is 0.25, it's greater than zero. And it's called a saddle because it has the shape of kind of a saddle that you put on top of a horse to sit and ride the horse. And you can see that it's stable, decaying in one direction, but unstable and exponentially growing in the opposite direction. if my eigenvalues have an imaginary component, so here there are actually degenerate eigenvectors because they're exactly the same. I can't plot the red one and the blue one because they're right on top of each other. There's two of them. And the corresponding eigenvalues are plus and negative I. You have, just like before in the one-dimensional system, stable oscillations. And stable oscillations in the context of a two-dimensional dynamical system actually gives you orbits. And these types of behaviors are really important because they're really convenient for modeling cyclic behaviors. So for example, neurons that fire and then slow down and fire and slow down. And people also use these for modeling systems of cyclic behaviors, such as rhythmic walking of all kinds. And your exercise is to simulate two-dimensional deterministic linear dynamical systems, just like the kinds we saw above. We are going to be visualizing these behaviors as trajectories in time and connect that with the four-phase portrait description of things. And then you're going to explore, qualitatively at least, the behavior of these systems. And my goal for you is for you to develop an understanding of how these behaviors are connected to the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix A.